Silence makes people uncomfortable because it violates our expectations. Did she forget her speech? Is her mic not working? Our brains prick up a little bit when we're not quite sure what's coming next. And during adolescence, this happens a lot. The adolescent brain, which is characterized roughly between the ages of 11 and 12 through the early 20s, is characterized by a high level of uncertainty because we're doing a lot of things for the first time. As a neuroscientist who has spent her career working to understand the adolescent brain, I've learned that all of the firsts, first job, first kiss, first time driving, first time doing anything really without our parents, are things that are filled with excitement and also a little bit terrifying because of the uncertainty. It's why adolescence is characterized by a full range of emotions. I certainly felt that way when I first moved away. When I left my hometown of Santa Barbara for college in New York City, I was a 17-year-old who thought I had a pretty good handle on life. But I had never seen snow, I'd never slept away from home, I'd never had my heart broken, I'd never eaten much else besides my mom's Mexican food. I had a lot to learn. The most daring thing I had ever done was to teepee a neighbor's house with my cheerleading squad. My parents were a little bit nervous for me. "But you'll be alone," my mom said. "But you'll be okay," my dad offered as a way of encouraging. It's a scary thing not to know what's coming next, isn't it? Especially now, we live in a time when anything we want the answer to, we can get immediately. This afternoon's yoga schedule, next week's weather, whatever happened to the person who eventually did break my heart, it's all there for us to find. But when it comes to our future, there's no app to predict what's to come. And this can be particularly unsettling in moments of transition. A few years ago, I taught a neuroscience course to a group of graduating seniors, and they humored me by taking a survey that asked what they were excited about and what they were most nervous about when it came to their upcoming graduation. More time, sleep, freedom, that's what they were excited about. But when it came to their future, they were a bit nervous. They were concerned that they would lose touch with loved ones or that they wouldn't love the job they had signed up for. Overall, there was a general sense of discomfort with the uncertainty of it all. So I felt compelled to remind them of a key insight from neuroscience, and that is that there's actually joy in not knowing what's coming next. It's what makes life interesting. And adolescents have this figured out, and that's why they're comfortable with uncertainty and learning from the trial and error of life. In my lab, we were interested in understanding what happens in the adolescent brain when they're taking risks. So we asked a group of adolescents and a group of adults to come to the lab and perform a risk-taking task while we took a picture of their brain using fMRI. We weren't surprised to see that the adolescents took more risks in general than the adults. What did surprise us is that they were better able at identifying the good risks on the task, and this was accompanied by activation in a brain region called the striatum that you see here. It's why adolescents are more comfortable taking risks, why they're more daring, why they're more likely to learn from the trial and error of life. Perhaps that's why I felt comfortable moving across the country. I still had those good risk-taking neurons propelling me forward. Adolescents learn by taking risks. In this way, they are like mini scientists. You try something out and see what happens. Sometimes it leads to exciting discoveries, and sometimes it leads to challenges or the opportunity to try something new. And this is a necessary part of growing up. Maybe it's the reason why we ever leave the nest in the first place. You see, nature doesn't make mistakes. It's no coincidence that we have more dopamine in the brain during adolescence, or that every species on Earth has a period in life when individuals are more likely to seek out new adventures or form new social bonds. As my own kids creep into adolescence, I try to remind myself that the adolescent brain is beautiful in this way, that it retains the flexibility of childhood, but has the adult ability to appreciate the future, think abstractly, and hone the social skills we need to understand others. When our kids are babies, we don't question this process of learning through trial and error, this process of learning through risk-taking. A baby learning to walk falls 100 times a day. That's a risk-taker. A baby learning to talk babbles before they produce speech. And this is all possible because of the changing brain, because of what's called the neuroplasticity in the brain that helps us retain new information and to try new skills and learn from them and form stronger connections because of them. During adolescence, there's a second wave of neuroplasticity. And this too helps adolescents reach their own developmental milestones. And this brain region, the striatum, is right there to help them do it. It's the part of the brain that is processing uncertainty and learning through trial and error. It's also the reward center in the brain. And during adolescence, it is more excitable than it ever will be at any other point in life. In a brain scanning study we did, we asked a group of kids, a group of adolescents, and a group of adults to come to the lab, and we gave them a lot of different rewards while we took a picture of their brain. No matter what type of reward we gave them, whether it was a drop of juice or a little bit of money or a simple, you did a great job, the adolescent brain was paying more attention to that reward. It was enjoying that reward more so than the kids and the adults in our study. We also found that the adolescent brain, the striatum in the brain, which is a key learning center, is tightly connected to the hippocampus, which you may know is the main learning center in the brain. With a collaboration with colleagues at Columbia University, we found that this connection between the learning centers is strongest during adolescence, and that this helped the adolescents become better learners from positive feedback as compared to adults. This was really exciting because it means that we can leverage it to help adolescents learn both inside and outside the classroom. It also has implications for the type of memories that are best remembered later in life. I'll give you a hint, it's the rewarding ones. Whether or not you have fond memories of adolescence, we can probably all remember a few key lessons that happened during that period in life. There's something called the reminiscence bump that explains this. The reminiscence bump is a tendency for adults to better recall events that happened during their adolescent years, more so than any other time in their lives. It's why adolescence is such a formative time for some key aspects like relationship building and forming musical preferences. It explains this article that the New York Times published a few years ago, showing that our strongest musical preferences are set during adolescence. If you love something as a teenager, you love it forever. Life events that happen during this period of the adolescence bump, graduation, romantic relationships, maybe your first real job, are all novel, and that's why we're drawn to them. Novelty is exciting for the brain. It keeps things fresh, and it's what we learn the most from. What you do, who you do it with, and what you learn from it during your teenage years helps define who you will be as an adult. Now, that's easy to say upon reflection as an adult and as an adult who studies adolescence. But many of us can think of this time fondly. Now, back to my graduating seniors. Another question I asked on the survey was, what advice would you give to incoming freshmen? And interestingly, it was about embracing uncertainty. They told them to put themselves out there, make new friends, join clubs, take courses outside of their major, and overall, not to worry about the mistakes they would inevitably make. That all of our failures, no one else is paying attention to them as much as we are. My own advice is that life will give you personal puzzles you can't imagine, passions you don't know you have, and people you haven't yet met that you will fall in love with. But for all of us, embracing the silent moments and the uncertain times in life, that's a superpower we can all enjoy. Mm-hmm.